Well, she burst into fame with Britain's Got Talent back in 2009 when she dreamed a dream, and of course, it came true. Susan Boyle went from a trainee cook in West Lothian in Scotland to one of the world's most loved popular singers. And now life has taken yet another twist with a new album and a new challenge. And Susan Boyle joins me now. Susan, good morning to you.
Good morning to you. How are you?
Very good. You've started your very first American tour. Your first ever since you came to fame in 2009. It took you 5 years. What took you so long, girl?
Well, the reason it took 5 years is you have to get an act together, first of all. You have to have some sort of format. So we had to really work on the format and make it to train before we actually set off to do anything.
Well, we've seen you performing down here in New Zealand. We knew that you had a great act. Why did you deny the Americans this for so long?
Well, it's not a question of denial. I didn't really deny the Americans anything. What we did was we did it in a measured way and at the right time. We didn't really feel that 2009 was really the right time to do things.
Yeah.
So we just held off for a while and just sort of worked on the act and there you go.
Yeah. And of course,
America
is so very important. You've got to do these things right. And well done, very clever. So whereabouts are you right now?
I'm in North Carolina.
Wow. And is this your first time in North Carolina?
It's my very first time, yeah.
What's it like?
It's been very pleasant so far.
Yeah, what's it like?
It's been very pleasant so far. What you can see from a hotel bedroom, it's very sunny.
And where have you been already?
Been to California, Arizona, Texas, Kansas City, Kentucky.
Wow.
To name but a few.
And are you finding the states different, you know, or are you finding the audiences different? What's your findings of what it's like to do the first ever Susan Boyle tour of North America?
Well, this can actually vary from place to place, but I find the audience is very open, very friendly, and has been really good. I've had some great audiences.
Yes, well, they really love you. I saw a Washington Post article about how much you are loved by America because you're like the American dream. You know, the anything is possible if you put your mind to it. So they really take you to heart, don't they?
Well, they seem to have taken me to heart. I mean, they come out to see me after the show, and they're very forward. They're very polite to me. I mean, they're fantastic to be with.
Great stuff. And you're still super busy. You've got a new album out.
Album number 6. It's entirely different from the usual, you know. I tend to offer surprises on it. Mm. You know, I don't want to say too much about it at the moment.
It's called Hope, and it's all about it's all the songs you've really wanted to do, isn't it?
The whole theme of the album is inspiration, and it's actually been songs which have been sort of inspirational, like Angel, like Wish You Were Here, to name two.
How does the Susan Boyle album come about? Is it you who drives it on? Because you've made a lot in 5 years, you have to say. Is it you who drives it on, or is it you know, Mr. Cowell who goes, righto, we want another out of you?
I don't think girls are demanding, really. You know, I think it's a sort of team effort, you know, between A&R and myself. It's a team effort.
Well, it's very good because you're very, very productive. I mean, like I say, 6 albums in 5 years is fantastic. Yes, you mentioned some of these songs, and they were quite interesting. I had a good listen to it last night, and you did Pink Floyd's Wish You Were Here. Now, that's quite a big song to try and do, and it's quite different, isn't it?
It's very abstract, as Pink Floyd's music is. It's very abstract, but it's a challenge as well, and I like to have a challenge.
Mm. You were quite brave. You did John Lennon's Imagine. That's quite a big song, isn't it?
It's quite a big song. It's hard to go up to the reputation, you know. Mm. But I like a challenge, and it's a very beautiful song to do, and I've always admired his songs.
Yes, and you put your own stamp on it too, and it sounds great. But I get the feeling, because you mentioned it first, and I just get the feeling that Sarah McLachlan's Angel is your current favourite. Would I be right?
You'd be right in assuming that Angel is my favourite. It features in the act in the show as well. It's a very moving piece.
And what is it about Angel that you've always loved?
Angel is about, it's a song for people who really can't be there with you.
Mm.
They have gone on to a happy place, Nice place. And Angel typifies that. Because that's where we go when we pass on. We go into another dimension. So Angel's a very moving song. And that can make you close to the people you've lost. They've been there with you all the time, so encouraging you. That's why it's a very good song for me.
Well, look, can I play the song right now, if that's all right?
You can.
And
you can.
Would it be fair that we're dedicating this to your mum and your dad? Your dad passing away, what, your mum, what, just a few years ago? Okay, so this is from mum and dad. What were their names?
Their names were Patrick and Bridget.
All right, from Susan Boyle's new album called Hope, this is Sarah McLachlan's song, Angel, for her mum and dad. Susan, it's a great album. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you very much. No problem.
Spend all your time waiting for that second chance, for a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason.
Sarah McLachlan's Angel, as performed by Susan Boyle, and she has got a knack of singing a great song. Good album. It's a very, very good album, and strange. Wish You Were Here, Pink Floyd, her version of it. I bet you can't even imagine it. Check it out. I've actually put an album sampler on my Facebook page, which has music from the whole album. It's called Hope, and it's in record stores now.